Hello guys, Diogo Snow aqui diretamente do Toronto Black Film Festival, fazendo essa matéria exclusiva para Camões TV. E hoje vamos estar mostrando esse festival maravilhoso que vem a fazer a diferença e promover o cinema, a arte e a cultura aqui no Canadá. E vamos também estar conversando com grandes nomes no meio dessa indústria que vem fazer a diferença para todos nós. I'm here with Joyce Fuerza. Ela, vamos dizer, ela é a coordenadora do Toronto Black Film Festival. I was gonna tell her in Portuguese, but she was like, wow, I didn't practice my Portuguese. Just say something in Portuguese.
Ah, meu português é muito mal. Então, não quero falar em português. Hoje vamos falar inglês.
See, that's amazing. Thank you very much for having us tonight. And just tell us a little bit of what's the Toronto Black Film Festival.
So the Toronto Black Film Festival now has its 6th edition, right? The main goal of the festival is to showcase black talents as well as black realities, black cultures happening from around the world. Because a lot of artists, they don't have the right platform to showcase their work, right? Especially black artists. So we're trying to showcase diversity, not only in Canada, but around the world. And we have artists coming from all over the place, and we're really happy about this year's edition. We even have a film in Portuguese from Brazil. So we have films from more than 20 countries. So we're very happy.
Then I heard this week you guys are going to be presenting the movie Boy 23. So can you tell us a little bit about this movie?
Yes. So Boy 23 is a film from Brazil. It's a Brazilian production. And the first time I saw it, I felt really touched because it's about a story in Brazil that I had never heard of. It's about Nazism, right? So Boy 23 is the story of 50 kids that were from an orphanage in Rio de Janeiro, and then they took them from a very young age for them to be slaves in São Paulo. During 10 years, okay, there were 50 black kids. So you can already imagine how tough that was. So in the documentary, one of those kids now, well, that he's, you know, in his adulthood, he's explaining his experience back then. So I think it's really a film that allows us to reflect, right? To think, to ask questions, and also relate it to realities from today. So I think everybody should be seeing that film.
Sure, nice. Yeah. And I know you're super busy. I know your time is precious. So just tell us, what's the expectation for tonight? Today is the first day, and tell us a little bit.
Tonight is the great opening night, right? Red carpet. We're very excited to welcome our guests. And of course, we're very happy to have Camões TV with us representing the Lusophone community. So we're very happy. And we have a great documentary screening tonight called The Rape of Recy Taylor. I think everybody should see that film too.
É isso aí, meus amigos da Camões TV. Eu, Diogo Snow, tô aqui, encontrei um grande parceiro brasileiro que está aqui fazendo a diferença no Canadá e é o grande diretor do filme Preto no Branco. Estamos com Walter Regi. E como está sendo sua noite, Walter?
Ah, tá sendo maravilhosa, assim, eu tô numa catarse total. Tava assistindo a Fabiane falar ali embaixo. Não sei falar inglês, na verdade eu não sei falar quase nada de inglês, só what's your name,
o básico.
Desculpa,
Conta pra gente como que foi você que dirigiu e você que escreveu esse filme Preto no Branco.
Exatamente. Na verdade, teve um edital chamado Edital Curta Afirmativo para Jovens Talentos Negros. E aí eu escrevi, né, uma história e dirigi. E isso foi em 2014. Em 2016, a gente filmou. Em 2017 a gente lançou, inclusive para vir aqui pro festival, né? Eu procurei ajuda de várias produtoras, de vários lugares para ajudar o vir, e aí eu não consegui, porque já passei em 4 festivais internacionais. E aí eu fiz uma vaquinha online para conseguir um determinado valor, R$7.500, né? Que é bem pouco se for
converter,
né? E aí eu consegui. Em 4 dias, porque eu também tenho um canal no YouTube, lá no Brasil, chamado Canal Energia Positiva. E aí a galera se mobilizou e eu consegui juntar esse dinheiro, né?
Como tá sendo sua estadia aqui? Você chegou hoje? Como é que é? Tudo diferente pra você? Essa neve?
Tá sendo maravilhoso, porque eu nunca tinha visto neve. Eu nunca tinha viajado de avião. Foram 10 horas de voo, né? Eu tô num hotel lindo, muito legal. Também eu consegui um auxílio pra ficar nesse hotel. Inclusive, eu tô fazendo um documentário, né, baseado nessa minha experiência, para poder exibir lá nas favelas do Brasil, né? Para tipo incentivar as crianças, as pessoas, enfim, que mora na periferia a correr atrás dos seus sonhos.
Walter Regi, muito obrigado mesmo, tá? Foi um prazer falar com você. Até a hora que a gente se encontrou ali, poxa, um brasileiro, fala português, que bacana isso. Fiquei muito feliz, você é um exemplo, cara. Muito obrigado mesmo. E a gente vai se ver ainda, cara.
Ah, com certeza. Amém.
Já tá caindo, Neguinho. Caiu. Vamos fechar. Então vamos lá, vamos trocar ideia. Vamos trocar ideia.
E a bolsa da vítima não apareceu ainda. Cadê a bolsa?
I'm here at the Toronto Black Film Festival with the founder and president, Fabienne Colas. How are you doing tonight?
Oh, thank you for being here. It's a pleasure. Boa noite.
Boa noite, Zé. Tell us a little bit of this event, what this represents to you.
Oh, this is, as you say, this is huge for the community and for us and for Black History Month, because it's an event that is growing very quickly. We're having more than 60 films from over 20 countries, and people are coming from the United States, from South Africa, from Haiti, from the USA, from Canada, from everywhere to come to the festival. This is fantastic.
Oh, that's amazing. And what's your expectation for tonight?
Oh, well, tonight it's the opening night.
Right.
You definitely need to get a shot at this theater to say to show how crowding it is. The film is called The Rape of Recy Taylor. Recy Taylor was a woman raped when she was young, a young mother, a young wife, and she was raped by 6 armed white men in the segregated south of the United States. And this is the first film made about her. And she was threatened to be killed, to be lynched, if she said, if she talked about that, if she talked about the people that raped her. And she spoke up anyway. This is a very powerful story. And we wanted to open the festival with that film because that's the only film that really resonated with us through the Me Too movement. We wanted to empower women so women can have, you know, can know more about what happened in the past. And also this film tells us that Black women have been standing up for so long against injustice, against inequalities, for better society.
Can you give any advice for actors, writers, or directors if they wanna start and be in the business? Any advice for them?
Well, the advice is you have to just go ahead and do your film. Go ahead and do your first film. Go ahead and do whatever you wanna tell, the story you wanna tell. Because by starting, you get to acquire experience, you get the knowledge, you get to see what works, what doesn't work, and you get to prove what you can do. You get to prove that you're serious about your craft. So I would say the first thing, today we have the internet, you can make a film with your phone.
True.
You can have a little small camera and then record on that. So don't wait for the big money or for whatever. It's nice to have the big money, but first do something. Do something for the web, do something, a web series, do some clips, send them on YouTube, send them on social media, get people to tell you, to give you feedback, to tell you whether or not it makes sense, it's good, it's not good, so you can gather an audience, gather a style, and then acquire experience. And at the end, it's gonna pay off, but you gotta be patient. Keep producing, keep working, keep posting on social media, keep doing your thing, keep going to festivals and then things like that. And then one day, damn, somebody's gonna be like, he's so good.
Yes.
I like this boy. Who is he? I like this woman. Oh, who has done that? So this is what I will say.
Amazing. Fabienne, thank you very much for your time. Thank you for having us. And yes, Fabienne Colas, everybody.
Obrigada.
Obrigada. É isso aí, galera. Aqui é o Diogo Snow, diretamente do Red Carpet do Toronto Black Film Festival. Espero que tenham gostado da matéria e fiquem ligados que tem muito mais. Valeu!